innovation, if it's good enough, can grab the spark and light a fire.
You're never going to succeed if you don't try. So you just jump right in.
I'm very excited to be taking a group of students from the University of Illinois to Israel. We're going to visit accelerators, incubators, we're going to meet with early stage VCs and serial entrepreneurs, and we're going to try and understand just what is it about this environment that creates so many successful startups.
We're with the Academy for Entrepreneurial Leadership, and we want Illinois to become a leader in startup creation.
We need to stop comparing ourselves to other states. We need to look at the most successful countries in the world. Israel has half the population of Illinois, and with an area of only 8,000 square miles, is 7 times smaller.
7 million is not real. How can this country be 7 million people and play this role?
In a given year, this sliver of a country creates more new startups than the continent of Europe and more startups per capita than the United States.
Just what's happening in Israel? It's such a small country with limited resources. Why are so many startups being created? What can we learn from this process?
We hopped off the plane and went straight for Jerusalem, where we met with a startup company called Oramed Pharmaceuticals.
Okay, I saw your schedule and I saw that you're
starting at 7 in the morning.
That's right. Sleep when you're dead.
I think what I can share with you today is a little bit of my story. You know, my personal story as an Israeli entrepreneur. When you talk about why is there successful companies here, because with little funding, they can get much further. For example, you see the modest office here? All the furniture that you see here, it's all secondhand.
In the year 2009, Israel saw 77 seed stage VC deals, whereas Illinois only saw 3.
Why? In other words, what happened here over the last, decades that drove this kind of, technology explosion? And it's all about culture, okay? In other words, in my opinion, it has nothing to do with brains. Brains are necessary, but not sufficient.
Is the best guy, the best engineers at Intel Israel better than the best engineers at Intel Santa Clara? No, they're not better. Are they intrinsically smart? No, they're not smarter. Why are they more successful here? For just this very reason. If you put together a team of 100 people to develop some specific thing like a Centrino or some very fancy device, and go back there 18 months later, I'm willing to bet you'll find 99, if not 100, are exactly the same people that started the project. If you take a team of 100 in Santa Clara and go back after a year, you'll find 70 or 80 of them, the originals. A lot of the time of the good people is spent bringing other people up to speed.
There is about a sense of camaraderie of people's friendship that the founding team or teams of people that do not very quickly disintegrate.
So a lot of the companies and VCs while we were in Israel talked about 2 degrees of separation.
When it comes to hitting the knowledge or to get to know somebody in Israel, then it's probably much less than the 3 degrees of separation.
How many degrees of separation are there between any two people?
We're in an interconnected world.
It's literally 2 degrees of separation.
In America, it's 7.
I mean, we can get to the Prime Minister, we can get to anyone we want to.
And in Israel, it's 2.
In business? It's a very, very small community.
2 degrees of separation in Israel, what does it mean? Well, what it means is that within just a few phone calls, just sending a few emails, you can validate an idea. You can get feedback on a concept. You can identify a potential partner. You could understand the credentials of somebody you're wanting to hire into your startup. This is a very powerful thing.
And you add one last secret sort of sauce, and that's the Israeli army, which I'm sure you've met with people from the army. But for here, it's not just the technology that comes from the army, but it's the culture of the Israeli army, where we give a lot of power to the junior officer corps. Junior officers here make incredible amounts of decisions.
What would be a group of engineers in America in the startup is a team of engineers here, because these guys know each other, they're in the military together, their kids go to the same kindergartens.
Now, I think the connections that are created in the military are for life.
Mm-hmm. So the security and the fact that we are surrounded by friendly and not such friendly nations, obviously.
Okay. That has nothing to do with high-tech or low-tech, biotech or clean-tech. It has to do with the fact that you want to achieve, you want to show that I can do better, that I can beat the system.
You have more IP, innovation, coming out of Israel per capita than anywhere in the world. You have more engineers per capita than anywhere in the world, which means a lot of people with ideas that are able to actually bring them to fruition.
Basically, the startup community here is very, very vibrant, and we try to tap the talent that is, you know, available here in Israel, both on managers and technology, and of course the capital that is available here.
They're patriots. It's a sort of a deep, sort of seems to be a social thing, and they want to contribute to the growth of the country.
One of the main reasons that Israel is so successful in creating such a entrepreneurial startup community is because all the main spheres of influence in that startup community, the government, the entrepreneurs themselves, and the investors, all have a shared vision.
But the doors are open. The doors are open. All you have to do is show up at the door.
And I find it very impressive that a lot of the very successful people who made a lot of money in VC-backed or other, they act as mentors, they sit on boards.
What we found in Israel is that veteran entrepreneurs are an important part of the mix. They're keen to give back, they're keen to mentor, they're keen to support, they're keen to create the next generation of startups in Israel.
When I was a venture capitalist, my biggest investor, my lead investor, would constantly sit down with us and say, take more risk. Most people, when you hear the word risk, risk sounds bad. Right? Risk has a pejorative connotation to it. Risky is risky business. Doesn't sound good, right? Except that you're not thinking like an entrepreneur. Risk is something good.
One of the things that really surprised us when we visited Israel was just how investors are so encouraging of entrepreneurs to take risks, and how entrepreneurs themselves actually took those risks because they simply weren't afraid of failure. In Israel, failure is success, and that's something you simply don't see in the United States.
In our society, we have a real fear of failure. We focus on their successes and the big hits, the big buyouts, and we don't talk at all about failures. But the reality is, a successful entrepreneur has failed.
Well, in Israel, if you failed once, people think that you've learned something out of it.
In Israel, failure is success.
It's important when entrepreneurs, for example, come to talk to the startup companies in our program, that they talk about their failures.
You learn so much when you fail that it is such an incredible experience and such an incredible learning opportunity that it's necessary for you to have for you to be successful.
Hello, Fighting Illini.
Hi, my name is...
My name is
Uchi Dahan.
Boaz Kantor.
This is Asaf Landau.
Ron Feldhey.
Steve Gray.
Limorna Carr-Vincent.
Cal Brody, Fighting Illini from 1961.
I'm the founder of Civilius.
Hey, I manage the Nisgav Venture Accelerator.
Founder of Evolve in Software.
A former venture capitalist turned tour guide.
3 years in Saludo.
Professor at Technion. In entrepreneurship.
US Israel by National Industrial Research and Development.
We need to conquer the world.
My role is preparing students to continue the saga of the startup nation Israel.
So now the question is, how do we bring all of this back to Illinois?
So how do we bring this back to Illinois? Well, it seems like we have all the key ingredients. We have the capital, we have the resources, we have the intellect. Maybe all we need is a change in attitude.
The startups really need to be more creative in how they bootstrap.
You have Groupon in Chicago, which is a huge success story. And as you have more success stories, you have more people that are in that world, that love that world, that buy into the idea that it's okay to give up some short-term incentive for a long-term future, for a long-term success.
When people think Illinois, they need to be thinking entrepreneurship.
I could see a lot of differences between the Israeli companies that we spoke to today and some of the companies that I've dealt with the launch program. To some degree, you would say that Israeli companies or Israeli startups deal with a lot more obstacles. They're forced to persevere and find some way to be resilient.
We have the resources here in Illinois. We just have to use them appropriately. We have to be frugal. We have to change people's tolerance for risk and willingness to accept failure.
For Illinois, it's something that we want to do is implore the government, the investors, and the entrepreneurs to kind of have that shared vision of creating that startup community. And in many ways, it is simply that change of attitude, but it has to be across the board and it has to be collective and cohesive.
If we can get people excited and involved, we can make a huge difference in the economy of Illinois.
I am very excited because there's such an amazing amount of great human resources in Illinois, one of the best in the country.
A little money can go a long way in Illinois. Real estate is relatively inexpensive. We have access to the tremendous resources here on campus.
The next challenge is really the idea of getting young, hungry, successful companies that can fill the gap and get that funding and take it to the next level.
And I think the role of the university is very crucial in promoting it and mentoring it, make sure that they stay in Illinois and make more success stories coming out of Illinois.
Startups.
Startup.
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 Let's start up Illinois.